Welcome all, it's Russ, and in this video, we're going to talk about how to loop over a range of integers. So, let's say that we want to loop over all ints from 0 to 100, but we want this to be an inclusive bound. Remember when we talked about slicing, inclusive bound means this number will be part of the range, and this is going to be an exclusive bound. Again, from slicing, exclusive bounds means not contained within. So we're talking about the numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, all the way up to 97, 98, and then ending with 99. All right, classic thing that we do all the time. How would we write this? Well, I'm first going to write the way that you would see it in C++ or Java. If you're coming from JavaScript, it looks almost identical. If you're not familiar with C++, Java, JavaScript, then just stick your fingers in your ears for a couple of moments because you don't need to know this. But I wanted to give the C++ version, C++. Java and JavaScript version, just so everybody knew that we are talking about the same basic thing. For int I equals 0, I less than 100, I plus plus. All right, that's the loop that we're going to do. But now we're going to do it in Python. In Python, we're going to write it like this. For I in range 100. All right, now we'll talk later on about what range is. This is actually a general purpose tool that you can use in lots of things other than for loops. But its simplest and easiest way of doing it is in a for loop. What we're doing here is that this is the variable. The variable is going to be I. The for and end are both keywords of the language. And this says what numbers. So if we say range 100, it's going to go from 0 up to 99. So if we say print I in the body of the loop, then this will print 0. And then on the next line, it'll print 1, then 2, 3, 4. All the way up to 99, but will not print 100. That's the essence of a loop in Python. You can, of course, do nested loops. For I in range 4, for j in range 2, print I, comma, j. Now, what does print I, comma, j do? Well, I'll tell you that. It's going to print I, and then a space, and then it's going to print j. Not a very advanced way of doing formatted printing, but we'll get more advanced as time goes by. Here's my challenge problem for you. I'm not going to show you the answer for this. I'd like you to go either type it up yourself and execute it, or better yet, work it out on paper. You got a loop here that loops through I, range 4. We got a loop over here that loops through J, range 2. What values will it print and in what order? Anything else you need to know? What if you do range 0? Then the loop doesn't run because it goes from 0 to not including 0, and so it never ever runs. And I don't know if I've ever tried range on a negative number. You could experiment with that yourself. So this is the key loop. What might you use it for? Well, you could use it for printing a whole bunch of things. You could print a whole bunch of numbers. But you could also use it for something like this. Let's have x equals input. I'm going to read the input from the user. For I in range len x. What's that going to do? It's going to take the variable x, which was whatever was read from the user, going to ask for the length of that string, and then it's going to do an arrange to iterate over that range. So if there are 10 characters in x, then it will do range 10, so it will iterate from 0 to 9. If we then do print x sub I, what is this going to do? This is going to print each one of the characters in the string, one per line. All right, so here we have for loops over integer ranges. Hope it's clear. Hope you've learned a bit. Hope you've learned a good amount. Bye-bye.